If you're setting up a new Windows 11 computer and don't like how Microsoft is requiring you to connect to the internet and either join or create a new Microsoft account, then this video is for you. Let me show you a few tricks that I use when setting up computers for my clients. So first, on this screen here where it says let's connect you to a network, you'll notice that the next button is grayed out and there's no option to skip it, so in a way you're kind of stuck. But you're not really stuck, here's a trick. So if you hold the shift key on your keyboard and push F10, a command prompt window will open. And if that did not, you might be on a laptop, and in order to get F10 to work, there's another button you have to also hold that says FN, or function, so it would be Shift FN F10. And then once this button opens, you have to type a few things here. It is OOBE, a backslash, which is not the question mark key, but the one above your enter key. And then it will be bypass NRO, and those are all letters. And go ahead and just hit enter there. The command executes, and then the computer reboots. So I'll skip forward to show you what happens after it gets all booted up again. So after the reboot, it went back to the region or country selection. So we'll go ahead and just go through that. And the keyboard layout, we'll just agree to everything here. Okay, and now it's back to the list connecting to a network page, and I do see I don't have internet, a selection on the bottom. So that's exactly what we're looking for. So I'll go ahead and click on that and see what happens. Okay, and then on this screen here, we want to click continue with limited setup. And it's okay to go ahead and enter a name into the box here. And password, if you just don't want a password, just click next. And for privacy settings, I usually just agree to all these. You can fine tune these if you want to. Okay, and it's actually going into the Windows user account. This is what you see the first time you log into a new account. This can take a few minutes, so just hang tight with it. And there's the Windows desktop. So if we dig in a little bit, we want to make sure we're on a local account, so we can go to settings, and then accounts on the left side. And there it is. So we have a user account called user, and it is a local account and administrator. So we did all that without having to connect to the internet or create a Microsoft account. So you're pretty much good to go on that. And so now would be a good time to click and join a Wi-Fi network or plug in your network cable, and you can continue from this point forward. Next, I'll show you what to do if you already connected to your Wi-Fi network or if you had the network cable plugged in when you started the Windows 10 installation. So here, I'll go ahead and join my home Wi-Fi network, and I'll show you a workaround that should get us right around the Microsoft account requirement. So it is good to give your computer a unique name, something short and descriptive. So if you have more than one computer, you'll know which one is being referenced. So I'll just call this one PC for simplicity. And here's the screen that Microsoft wants you to sign in. So let's say that you've already connected to your network. Our only option is to click sign in. And then there's a little trick that I found on the internet that worked for a lot of people. If you enter an account and then are asked for the password for the account and you get it wrong several times, it actually will skip creating the Microsoft account. So a lot of people say no@thankyou.com for the email address. So let's put that in there. And then click next. And of course, we don't know a password on this one, so we're just gonna put a bunch of random stuff in there and hit sign in. Of course, it won't work, but that's our plan. Okay, oops, something went wrong. That's good, that's what we want. And then next. And now it just jumps right to who's going to use the computer. So I'll go ahead and put my name in there, click next. I don't want a password at the moment. I'll go ahead and click next. And the privacy settings come up. I'm going to just agree to everything for now. And click accept. And just like before, the new account configuration screens appear, and we just have to wait that out. All right, now up comes the Windows desktop. And let's just check on the account setting to make sure we're on a local account. There it is. It's got my name. It says local account and administrator. So we are good to go. So even if you are connected to the internet, there is a way to bypass the requirement to create a Microsoft account. So hopefully this helped you a whole bunch. I could see it becoming very useful if you're setting up a new computer for a friend or family member. Or let's say you've got an office full of 20, 30 computers and you don't want to keep using your own personal Microsoft account just to get them up and running. So if this helped you a bunch, please give me a like and subscribe to my channel. And I plan on making more videos in the near future. Thank you so much and have an awesome day.